Hello friends, welcome to Civil Engineering MCQ channel. Today we are going to learn some important questions regarding highway engineering. This video helpful for PWD, WRD, RRB, JEE, MIDC, ZP exam. So let's start. First question, third road development plan was prepared for the period of? Your correct answer is option D, 1981 to 2001. The answer to this question is D. Name of road, plan, period, density and pattern. The road length of national highway by third road plan formulae. The first one, Nagpur road plan. The period is 1943 to 1963. This is the density 16 km per 100 km square. This pattern is star and grid pattern. Bombay road plan 1961 to 1981. The density is 32 km per 100 km square and star grid pattern. Lucknow road plan, the period is 1981 to 2001. The density is 100 km square per 82 km and the pattern is star and grid pattern. Question number 2, keeping all other parameters as a constant, the ratio of mechanical winding in case of 6 lane to 4 lanes will be? Your correct answer is option C, 1.50. The answer to this question is C, mechanical winding. The definition of mechanical winding, the winding required to the account for the off-taking due to rigidity of wheelbase is called mechanical winding. Use this formula, Wm equal to nl square upon 2r, where n equal to number of lanes, n1 upon n2, 6 upon 4 equal to 3 by 2 equal to 1.5. This is our answer is 1.5. Question number 3, the height of mountable type of curb is about dash centimeter above the pavement edge. Your right answer is option A, 10. The answer to this question is A. Low curb or mountable type of curb encourages traffic to remain in this through the traffic lanes. It allows to driver to enter the shoulder area at slow speed. The height of this curb is about 10 cm above the pavement edge. Question number 4. In a bituminous construction, which of the following is used to waterproof the pavement surface and to prevent infiltration of surface water? Your correct answer is option C, bituminous surface dressing. The answer to this question is C, bituminous surface dressing. It is provided over a prepared base course or existing pavement to serve as a thin wearing coat. The surface dressing does not add to the structural stability or strength of pavement, nor will it improve the existing riding quality of pavement surface. Question number 5. As per IRC recommendation, what should be the value of camber for concrete and bituminous surface in case of light rainfall? Correct answer option B, 1.7%. The answer to this question is B, cement concrete high type bituminous surface, thin bituminous surface. The first one, heavy rainfall, 1 in 50 or 2%. Second one, low rainfall, 1 in 60 or 1.7%. So this is our answer is B. Question number 6. The ductility test of bituminous material is conducted at dash and at a rate of pool of dash per minute. This question was asked to the exam PWD 2018. So correct answer is option B, 27 degrees Celsius and 50 mm respectively. The correct answer is B. Ductility test is the carried out the bitumen test of adhesive property of bitumen and its ability to scratch. The first point is the standard brickweight specimen has a minimum cross section is 10 mm into 10 mm. The second one, the test is conducted 27 degrees Celsius with the rate of pull is 50 mm per minute until the scratched specimen breaks. Question number 7. On horizontal curve, if the pavement is kept horizontal across the alignment, then the pressure on the outer wheels will be? The answer to the 7th question is B, more than the pressure on inner wheels. The answer to the 7th question is B. On horizontal curve, if the pavement is kept horizontal across the alignment, then the pressure on the outer wheels will be more than the pressure on inner wheels.
Question number 8. Which of the following is not a traffic control signals? Option number D is the right answer. Pedestrian signal is not a traffic control signals.
Answer to the 8th question is D. Different type of traffic signals are used in India, namely first one manually operated signals, second one fixed type automatic signals, and the third one is automatic traffic acuted signals. There are three types.
Question number 9. Which one of the following test is conducted to evaluate the hardness property of aggregates? The right answer is option D, abrasion test.
The answer to the 9th question is D, Los Angeles abrasion test, used to evaluate the hardness and also toughness. Abrasion tests on aggregate are generally carried out any one of the following methods. The first one Los Angeles abrasion test, second one Dewell abrasion test, and the third one Dory abrasion test. There are three tests on aggregates.
10th question. What is the value of passenger car unit PCO for car on a urban roads? Your right answer is option A, first.
10th question answer is A. PCO values recommended by the IRC for a different type of vehicles on a road in rural areas. Serial number, vehicle class, and equivalency factors. The first one is motorcycle, scooter, pedal cycle. The equivalency factors is 0.5. Second one, passenger car, pickup van, and auto rickshaw. Equivalent factors is 1. Agriculture tractor and the light commercial vehicles is equivalency factors is 1.5. The last one, cycle rickshaw, is equivalency factors is 2. So answer to the 10th question is A.
Question number 11. By conducting which one of the following test, modulus of subgrade reaction is evaluated? Your right answer is option A, plate bearing test. To answer these questions is A, plate bearing test. The plate bearing test is used to evaluate the supporting power of subgrade instead for a use in pavement design by using relatively large diameter of plates. It is originally devised to find the modulus of subgrade reaction in Westergaard's analysis for a wheel load traces in rigid pavement.
Question number 12. At which of the following temperature penetration test is conducted on bitumen? Correct answer to this question is B, 25 degrees Celsius. The correct answer is B, penetration test. It is widely used for classifying bitumen into different grades. The basic principle of penetration test is the measurement of the penetration of standard needed in a bitumen sample maintained at 25 degrees Celsius during 5 seconds. 80 upon 100 bitumen denotes that the penetration value of binder ranges between 80 and 100, and the penetration values grade of bitumen binders are denoted as 80 upon 100, 60 upon 70, 30 upon 40 grade of bitumen.
Question number 13. The design value of coefficient of lateral friction is taken as? Your right answer is option A, 0.15.
Answer to this question is A. The minimum value of lateral friction coefficient of F taken for a design of highways except expressways is 0.15.
Question number 14. Which of the following shape of transition curve is recommended by Indian Railways? Your right answer is option C, cubic parabolic.
Correct answer to this question is C. The different types of transition curve commonly adopted in a horizontal alignment of highways are first one, spiral, ideal transition curve highway IRC, second one, Lamminskate Attoghanian curve, and the last one, cubic parabola, used for railway.
Question number 15. Which of the following test is conducted to evaluate the shape of property aggregate? Your right answer is option C, soundness test.
Correct answer C, shape test. The evaluation shape of particle is made in terms of flakiness index, elongation index, and angularity numbers.
Question number 16. As per IRC recommendation, what should be a width of carriageway for a two-lane roads with no curb? Your right answer is option A, 3.75 meter. Answer to this question is A. Width of carriageway recommended by IRC. This is the classes of road and its width of carriageway in meter. The first one, single lane road, equal to 3.75 meter. Second one, two lanes without raised curb, 7 meter. The last one, two lanes with raised curb, 7.5 meter. So answer is A. Question number 17. Which one of the following formula is used for the calculation of intermediate side distance? SSD, stopping side distance, OSD, overtaking side distance. Your right answer is option A, 2 into SSD, means stopping side distance. The answer to this question is A, intermediate side distance. The measurement of ISD may be made assuming both height of eye level of the driver, the object to be 1.2 meter above the road surface. ISD formula equal to 2 into SSD, means stopping side distance. Question number 18. In highway engineering, which one of the following is the range of design value of longitudinal friction coefficient? Your right answer is option B, 0.35 to 0.4. The answer to this question is B. The IRC has specified design friction coefficient values of 0.35 to 0.40 depending upon the design speed. For finding the braking distance, calculation of stopping side distance. Question number 19. As per IRC recommendation, what should be the width of carriageway for two lane roads with raised curb? Your right answer option D, 7.5 meter. Question number 20. Which one of the following substance is blend with bitumen for production rapid curing cutting bitumen? Your right answer option A, petrol. The answer to this question is A. Cutback bitumen is obtained by a bending bitumen binder with a suitable volatile diluents and solvents in the required proportion to reduce its viscosity to the desired range. So answer to this question is A, is the right answer. Question number 21. Which of the following light reflecting device are used to guide the driver along proper alignment? Right answer A, declinators. Answer is A. Declinators are tall pylons mounted on the road surface along the edge of road and are used to channelize traffic. The second point is, declinators part are used alert pedestrian, motorist, driver to work risk, parking lot of traffic control, stripping and resurfacing areas, border limits protect people and to be able to prevent injuries. So, correct answer is A. Question number 22. Which of the following traffic volume is considered in design of road geometries in India? Correct answer A, 30 highest hourly traffic volume. Correct answer is A. The highest hourly volume is generally taken as the design hourly volume for the purpose of design of roadway facility. Second point is, 13th highest hourly traffic volumes that will be reached only 30 times or exceeded only 29 times in a year. So answer to this question is A. Question number 23. Which one of the following test is conducted to evaluate the strength property of aggregate? The correct answer is option A, crushing test. The answer to this question is A. The strength of coarse aggregate may be assessed by aggregate crushing test. The aggregate crushing value is the percentage of crushed material passing 2.36 mm sieve in terms of original weight of the specimen. Strong aggregate give a low aggregate crushing value. So answer is A. Question number 24. For which one of the following purpose moving car observer method is adopted? Correct answer A, to determine traffic flow. The answer to this question is A, moving car observer method is adopted to determine traffic flow. Question number 25. For the calculation of stopping side distance, the reaction time of driver may be taken as? Right answer A, 2.5 seconds. The answer is A. The IRC has recommended the value of reaction time T as 2.5 seconds as per the calculation of stopping distance. Question number 26. Which one of the following percentile speed is considered as upper safe unit for vehicles? Right answer B. 85 percentile speed. Answer to this question is B. Desired speed values. The first one, upper speed limit for regulation 85 percentile speed is 60 km per hour. Second one, lower speed limit for regulation 15 percentile speed is 30 km per hour. The last one, speed to check geometric design 98 percentile speed is equal to 84 km per hour. So correct answer is B. Question number 27. Which one of the following is the most important factor in the design of Summit curve on highways? Correct answer A. Side distance requirement. Correct answer is A. Summit curve and the crest curve width conversely upward. The only problem is designing Summit curve is to provide accurate side distance as far as possible safe overtaking side distance or at least intermediate side distance equal to twice the stopping side distance should also be available on this curve for important highways. There is no problem of discomfort to passengers on Summit curve. Question number 28. During CBR value determination, load sustained by a standard aggregate at 5 mm penetration is taken as. Right answer C. 2055 kg. Question this C. California bearing ratio test. It is used for evaluating strength of subgrade soil and the other pavement materials for the design construction of flexible pavement. Second point, it is the empirical test method. Third one, the CBR test denote a measure of resistance to penetration of soil. Last one, standard load values on crushed stone aggregates for specified penetration values. This is the penetration in mm and its standard load in kg and unit standard load in kg per centimeter square. The first one, this is the penetration, first one 2.5 mm and standard load in 1370 and unit standard load is 70 kg per centimeter square. Second one, 5 mm standard load in 2055 and the last one unit standard load is 105 kg per centimeter square. Question number 29. A flat camber of how much value is sufficient on relatively impervious pavement surface like a cement concrete or bituminous concrete? Right answer C option 1.7 to 2%. Question number 30. As per IRC recommendation, what should be the value of camber for concrete and bituminous surface in case of light rainfall? Your right answer option B, 1.7%. Question number 31. In which one of the following plans, star and grid pattern was adopted? Right answer option A, Nagpur road plans. Question number 32. Which one of the following test is conducted on bitumen to evaluate the consistency property? Right answer option D, viscosity test. In this question is D, viscosity test. Viscosity is the measure of resistance to flow of the liquid. Viscosity test is conducted on bitumen to evaluate the consistency property by using orifice type viscometer. Question number 33. Which one of the following test is conducted to evaluate the weathering property of aggregate? Correct answer option C, soundness test. Answer to this question is C, soundness test, ductility test and accelerator weathering test. First point, it is intended to study the resistance of aggregate to weathering action by conducting accelerated weathering test cycle. Second one, the resistance to disintegration of aggregates is determined by using saturated solution of sodium sulfate or magnesium sulfate as per the BIS. Third point is, IRC has specified the maximum permissible loss in weight after 5U wet and dry cycle as 12% with sodium sulfate and 18% for magnesium sulfate. So correct answer is C. Question number 34. Which one of the following shape of transition curve is recommended by Indian Road Congress? So correct answer is option B, spiral. Question number 35. On the basis of which one of the following desire line are drawn? Correct answer C. Origin Destination Studies.
Correct answer C. Origin and Destination Studies. The OND studies provide to basic data for determine the desired direction of vehicular flow or passenger trips in terms of desired lines. Second one, desired lines are straight lines joining the points of origin destination of each trip. And third point is OD studies on vehicular traffic are initial for either comprehensive planning of a new road network for improvement in the existing road networks.
Next point is, these studies needed to scientifically solve many traffic or travel problems in a region or city scientific planning of transportation system and mass transit facilities in cities should be based on OD data of passenger trips. And method of conducting OD studies, the first one, roadside interview method, second one, license plate method, third one, written postcard method, fourth one, tag on car method, and the last one, home interview method. These all methods in OD studies.
Question number 36. As per IRC recommendation, what should be the width of carriageway for a single lane? Right answer A. 3.75 meter.
Question number 37. Which one of the following percentile speed is considered as lower safe limit for vehicles? Option A is the right answer, 15th percentile speed.
Question number 38. The weight of vehicle affects the design of. This question is asked to Town Planning Exam 2018. The correct answer B. Pavement thickness of gradient of a road.
Correct answer B. Weight of vehicle will be used for the first one, pavement thickness calculation, and the second one, restrictions of gradient. So answer this question is B.
Question number 39. For CBR test on soil subgrade, the standard load values obtained from the average of 2.5 mm to 5 mm penetration are. This is also question asked to Town Planning Exam 2018. So correct answer is C option, 1370 kg and 2055 kg.
Question number 40. Cement concrete road can be laid over. Right answer C. WBM road of thickness greater than 150 mm and subjected to traffic for a month.
Correct answer C. Cement concrete road can be laid over a WBM road of thickness greater than 150 mm and subjected to traffic for a month. So correct answer is C.
Question number 41. According to a third road development plan, which one of the following categories of roads is included in the secondary system? Correct answer C. Major district roads.
The answer to this question is C. Third 20-year road development plan is 1981 to 2001 Lucknow road plan. Classification of road. The first one, primary road system. Another part is expressway and the national highway. Secondary road system, another types of it, state highway and major district roads. And third one, tertiary road system, first one, other district road, and the second one, village roads. All these types of road in classification of roads.
Question number 42. To avoid overturning and lateral skidding on a horizontal curve, the centrifugal ratio P upon W should always be where the symbol have their usual meanings. Correct answer D, less than B upon 2H and F both.
The answer to this question is D. Explanation of this question is, if P upon W is less than F equal to no skidding, and second one, if P upon W is less than B upon 2H, no overturning. The correct answer D.
Question number 43. One important principle of interlocking is. Correct answer A. Point should be capable only when the signal is set on.
Correct answer A. The principle of interlocking is points should be capable only when the signal is set on.
Question number 44. The minimum coefficient of lateral friction highway is. Correct answer option D. 0.15.
Question number 45. If the overtaking side distance OS on a highway is 200 meter, the desirable and minimum length of overtaking zone will be. The correct answer is option D, 1000 meter and 600 meter respectively. The answer to this question is D. Given data OSD 200 meter, find desirable length of overtaking zone OSD. This formula 5 into OSD. So keep these values 5 into 200 equal to 1000 meter. And the second one, minimum length of overtaking zone. This formula 3 into OSD. To keep these values formula 3 into 200 equal to 600 meter. So correct answer is in this question is D.
Question number 46. For side distance calculation, time of perfection and reaction depends on. Correct answer C. Alertness of driver.
Correct answer C. Perfection time is the time required to pursue on object or situation. Second one, the perfection time reaction time depends on alertness of driver. And third one, total reaction time average driver may vary from 0.5 second for simple situation.
Question number 47. The speed distribution of vehicles at a point on the roadway is represented as. Correct answer, time means speed.
The answer to this question is B. The first one, space means speed. It represents the average speed of vehicles in a certain road length at any time. Second one, time means speed. It represents the speed distribution of vehicles at a point on the roadway and it is average of instantaneous speed of observed vehicles at the spot. And the third one, running speed. It is the average speed maintained by a vehicle over a particular stretch of road while the vehicle is in motion. It is obtained by subtracting the stopped delays from the total or journey time. Okay, the right answer is B.
Question number 48. Bitumen stabilization acts as a. Correct answer, option C. Destroyer of organic matter and hence more.
Correct answer, option C. Bitumen stabilization acts as a destroyer of organic matter and hence more strength.
Question number 49. The shape of regulatory signs for road users of stop and give way signs are respectively. Correct answer, option D. Octangle and triangular.
The answer to this question is D. Regulatory sign, also called as mandatory sign. These signs are meant to inform the road users of certain laws, regulation, prohibition. All regulatory and mandatory signs are circular in shape with only two exceptions. They are the first one stop sign, octangle shape. The second one give way sign, inverted triangle. So correct answer is D.
Question number 50. As per IRC suggestion, for the calculation of stopping side distance, the height of eye level of driver and the height of object above the road surface respectively are. The correct answer, option A, 1.2 meter and 0.15 meter.
The correct answer, option A. IRC has suggested the height of eye level of driver as 1.2 meter and the height of object as 0.15 meter above the road surface. So correct answer is A.
Last question in this video, 51. Which one of the following is and are typical physical pavement failure? The correct answer is option A, alligator cracking.
The answer to this last question is A, flexible pavement failure. There are three types. The first one, alligator cracking. Second one, consolidation of pavement layers. And the last one, shear failure.
Here this video is finished. I hope these videos will be helpful for you. More updates, subscribe to my channel and don't forget to share this video with your friends.